It looks like it could be a tense round of the championship here as we prepare to get today's race underway. It's an unusual anti-clockwise race here at Interlagos, where the Sao Paulo locals are packed into the grandstands at each of the 15 corners around this classic 2.7-mile circuit. Two very fast sections bookend the famous and highly technical Sector 2, where getting a good run out of Junsao into one of the two DRS zones will be the key to any overtaking prospects today. Also here, of course, is Anthony Davidson.
Why don't we kick off by discussing Max Verstappen? That was a great win in the last race. Can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
It's always nice to come into a Grand Prix weekend on a high, but your expectations are based much more on your practice and qualifying runs. So it's the momentum from those sessions that they'll be hoping to carry into the race today.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Young superstar Max Verstappen starts from pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Leclerc, Albon, Sebastian Vettel, and Bottas, Perez, Sainz, Kvyat, and Lance Stroll, Ricciardo, Norris, Esteban Ocon, and Gasly, Raikkonen, Magnussen, Romain Grosjean, and Nicholas Latifi, Russell, and Antonio Giovinazzi starts from the back of the grid. Now, it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. Keep pushing. Let's capitalize on that first lap. Job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. advise moving to mix 2, fuel to mix 2. Tyre condition is still looking good. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the hards. This lap, push hard on the in lap. Thank you. Great, go now. Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. Use your overtake button more, it's time to utilize some of this energy. Alexander is coming in for his stop. Okay, the gap behind is 5.0 seconds. to be able to run in this engine mode much longer. We're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix two soon. Full course caution. The safety car is out. Keep an eye on the delta. We need to keep it positive to avoid a penalty. Slow down, maintain positive delta. Coming up to the safety car now. Do not pass it. You are the leader. Follow the safety car. approaching the safety car. You're leading, so don't pass it. Stay behind the safety car. The safety car is coming in this lap. We'll be pacing the field in sector 3. Make sure to respect the delta until the safety car is in the pit lane. Okay, clear. Was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Thank you. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. To worry about tire condition for now. Everything's looking good. Two laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. We'll be right back. That's a race win. You've really been great today.
We've witnessed some great battles around the historic curves of Interlagos today, and they've taken a fantastic win. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
Well, the safety car completely changed the race, didn't it? It's hard to say exactly what would have happened without it, but there's no question that they came out of that situation in a good position.
The drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everyone at the team. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Carlos Sainz certainly wasn't someone to scoff about. His ability to follow race strategies throughout with pinpoint precision has to be commended.
And it's another title in the bag for Red Bull. After a long and hard-fought season, they built an astonishing car this year, and the glory they'll be taking back to Milton Keynes is fully deserved. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.